By installing ground services in X-Plane, it is now possible to solve two problems in one go. Adding truck traffic in an airport, which makes it lively, providing service and pushback to the planes, for instance refueling, which adds realism. This video concentrates on how to implement ground traffic. In addition, one video in the description provides background on how real service truck traffic is organized in a real airport. With any X-Plane release, there is an X-Plane folder called X-Plane Specs from Austin, which contains insights about new features. Ground traffic is documented in the Ground Traffic in X-Plane file. We can add ground traffic for custom airports only. There are many websites available to download custom airports. The X-Plane Scenery Gateway is often very useful because it contains all airports which are candidate for integration into X-Plane updates. We may download the recommended version of an airport from there to create a custom airport. Now let's open PlaneMaker and select the plane of interest. Let's choose the viewpoint option and the dock ports tab, and we can position the docking places for our plane. We have to push the space key to see the wire view and docking places. Docking places are defined in the local coordinate system of the plane. We can set that the nose of the fueling truck, for instance, will stop at the point defined by its longitudinal, lateral, and vertical distance from the center of gravity of the plane. We close PlaneMaker and save the changes to the plane. We open World Editor. World Editor can add ground traffic from version World Editor 1.6 only. First, check that your export target is X-Plane 11. Push the track parking button and choose the type of vehicle that will move along in the airport. They are artificial intelligence, AI for short, vehicles. They move autonomously according to a set of program rules. In their current state of development, they tend to go through everything but to avoid other artificial intelligence vehicles. When you click on the view, it positions the parking spot for the selected vehicle. After moving along in the airport, the vehicle will come back to exactly the same position it had initially, therefore to the same latitude, longitude, and heading. If you select the baggage train, You can choose the number of baggage cars in the train. For each type of vehicle, you must select the destination. The destination may be, for instance, a gas pump for a fuel truck. When you click on the view, this will position the destination for the selected vehicle type. By the way, it seems that destination heading has no effect on the vehicle behavior. We push the track roads button, selecting the option Ground Tracks. It is advisable to give names to the track roads. The slope field does not seem to me of vital interest. According to the Word Editor manual, the slope field indicates how close your point must be to another taxiway section in order to snap to it. Large numbers allow the paths to snap together from farther away. We now draw a truck road. Normally, truck roads are not too far from parking places, plane to serve, and destination. But I do not know the exact distance criteria for success. One destination may very well apply to several vehicle types. We can also position several destinations for a given vehicle type. The vehicle will randomly move to any of the specified destinations. However, it will stop only once when moving on a given track road. Although this is not typical, a track road is not mandatorily a closed loop, but may be open. We are allowed to draw several truck roads for one airport. For instance, one will serve general aviation and another one will serve the liners. As stated in the specs from Austin, if the airport has several truck roads implemented, any plane parked closest to a truck road will only demand service from trucks that are also closer to that truck road than any other truck road. We can see in this schema a parking place, a truck road, a destination, and the plane to be served. When ground services have been installed, vehicles go from parking spot to destination, using the truck roads in between, even without any plane on the airport. When called by the plane, the trucks will go in straight line from their parking spot to the nearest bit of the truck road they can find, and go in straight line from the truck road to the aircraft parking spot. When our traffic is defined, we validate Control Shift V to display possible errors. We save as usual in Word Editor with Control S and export scenery pack Control B. To request services for the plane, there is a menu option Show Ground Handling Window or Shift J. If pushback is considered, we must first release the brakes of the plane. When no ground service has been implemented in an airport, and we still push the Request Ground Service button, we get voice messages such as,
"Sorry, no service at this airport. Sorry, no service here. Sorry, we don't have any service trucks here. Try a bigger airport for service."
When no push cart has been implemented in an airport, and we still push one of the three pushback buttons, we get voice messages such as,
"Sorry, no push carts at this ramp. Try a different ramp or bigger airport. Sorry, no push carts here at this ramp."
When ground service has been implemented, and no plane has called for service, the service trucks move automatically from their parking spot to their destinations. When ground service has been implemented and we call for service, we get an answer such as,
"Sending service now. All right, service is on the way. Okay, they're on the way. All right, I got the service request."
The truck stops with the nose at the defined docking place. If we have already positioned a pushback cart, when we call for pushback, we get an answer such as,
"Push cart on the way. Okay, push cart coming. Okay, I'll send the push cart."
All trucks leave and a pushback cart comes instead. This works on a ramp only. To implement ground traffic in an airport, use a custom airport, position docking places for your plane in PlaneMaker, use a space key for visualizing the docking spaces in PlaneMaker. Use Word Editor version 1.6 or more. Export target is to be Iceplane 11. Enter parking spots, truck routes, and destination in Word Editor. In Explain, call Service Display Ground Handling Window, Shift G.